This morning to the Rhode Show Kitchen we go, where Go Providence has been kind enough to bring us this man. To my left, it's Chef Rolando Robledo. Good morning, sir.
Good morning. How are you?
I am great. Thank you so much for being here. He is from the Boathouse. Oh, who doesn't love the Boathouse? A tremendous spot. Absolutely magnificent. And today, we'll talk about the Boathouse in a minute, but we are making fall gnocchi with local seafood.
Yeah, we're having a good time. We're going to be featuring local Hake. It's relative to the cod, actually a firm flesh, firm fish,
cool,
light flake, and then we're going to be featuring some beets with that, as well as celery.
Yeah, take us through some of the ingredients here. We'll get a nice close-up of these. I mean, they all look so delectable, but what will we be working with here today?
So we're going to be working with some beet. I made a puree out of it. We're going to make that into a gnocchi dough, mm-hmm. A very delicate dumpling, if you will. This right here is a celery root.
Awesome.
That's the root of the celery branch, and we're going to take that and put that into a puree, as well as a vegetable side.
Outstanding. Now, when I stand here before you in the kitchen looking at these ingredients, I think, well, there's a lot here to work with, but it's really not that simple. And even if people are intimidated, you can kind of simplify this for us so that way we can kind of make some sense of what you're doing.
Absolutely. Cooking is actually, when you compartmentalize it, it's actually pretty simple, but when you actually add components on top of components, it actually makes it a little bit more complicated.
So. Sure, but you being the master chef that you are from the Boathouse, you can take us through, you can guide us. And for people unfamiliar with the Boathouse, give them the address. Where are you located?
We're located at 227 Schooner Drive in Tiverton, Rhode Island.
It is an absolutely tremendous place, picturesque, serene. Every foot of that place is a postcard, whether you're inside, outside. It's absolutely beautiful. If people have never been, they need to check it out.
Yeah, it's a pleasure. Every day I go to work, and my office overlooks the water right there. It's magnificent.
Why'd you come here? You should have stayed there. All right. Well, this is the guy. Chef Rolando is here all morning long. We're making the fall gnocchi with local seafood. You don't want to miss it. For now, back over to you.
Thanks, Brennan. We are back in the Rhode Show Kitchen. Thanks to our friends at Go Providence. Chef Rolando is here from the Boathouse. We got fall gnocchi with local seafood on the menu. What are you going to do right now?
Right now, I'm just basically I'm making this beet gnocchi. I just took some beet puree.
Okay.
I baked a potato.
I love beets.
It's great, right?
Yeah.
And look at the color. So what I did was I took a potato, baked it, scooped it out, added some flour, some egg, some spices, mm-hmm. and then I just made this pretty much like a pasta dough.
Okay.
Then I'm just going to cut a small piece of that out onto my board. Sort of like...
It looks like pizza dough. It has the same consistency of a pizza dough.
Yep.
Even though it looks like Play-Doh, it's not.
Yep. So basically what I'm doing is just going to roll it out into a sort of a snake, like you're a kid playing with Play-Doh.
Yep.
And then you want to have a little tackiness to it. And then you're just going to roll it out. And you can see I have a couple already done here.
All right.
So then, once that happens, what you'll do is you'll just cut out. You cut out your gnocchi.
Okay. Now, as far as this, after you do this, I know you have some water over here ready to go. This is pretty simple to piece together. Are we dropping this right in?
Yeah, pretty much what we're going to do here is we're going to just grab some of these.
Okay.
And just parboil them.
All right. So they really don't even have to sit in this for very long.
Nope.
Put that on. We can turn that up just a little bit. For everybody does note, too, the Boathouse is one of those restaurants in Rhode Island that, you know, I don't think you're a Rhode Islander if you haven't been to the Boathouse, because you do. You've got a great view where you are and everything else, and all local and all fresh. So it doesn't get you probably fish right out the back there.
Absolutely. Our oysters are right from the Sakonnet River right there. We're actually doing a sunset hour. Special right now, half price appetizers.
Sure.
From 4 to 6, Monday through Friday.
So it's a lot going on.
So we're having a great time.
A lot going on. And this is perfect for this time of year, a great fall menu. We will put this together, show you how simple and easy it is to do. Back to you. We are back in the Rhode Show Kitchen, wrapping things up with Chef Rolando. The Boathouse is the place. It's one of those places everybody around knows. We got fall gnocchi with local seafood on the menu. We were sampling some of the beets. I love beets. We're ready to go.
All right, here we go. So okay. I'm just going to season some of this hake right here.
Okay.
A little salt and pepper.
And what do people need to look for when they're going out and buying something like this, when they're going out and buying a piece of fish like this?
Mostly it's just freshness, so you want to look at the texture.
Okay.
If it's a whole fish, you want to look at the eyes, look at the gills.
Got
See the bounce of the flesh. Those are things that we look for as chefs.
Sure.
So I'm just going to add a little oil to this pan.
Okay. Is that a little olive oil or?
Just a little grapeseed oil.
Grapeseed oil, okay.
Yep. And then that's nice and hot. And then I'm just going to
Drop that in.
Drop that right in. Get a good sear on that. Let that go. And
now, does the grapeseed oil add a different flavor to it than if someone was to add something like an olive oil to it?
Olive oil is very healthy, but it has a good flavor. Grapeseed oil is something that you're primarily using just as a cooking medium, so okay. It has a high smoke point.
Got it.
So you can actually sear something hotter with a grapeseed oil.
All right. Okay. Good to know.
So here I'm going to start with the gnocchi preparation. Over here, you can see I have a little celery root puree.
Looks good.
That's heating up. That got made with a little potato in it, as well as some celery branch.
Sounds good. Okay.
So here, what I'm going to do is get this nice and hot, and I'm going to sear, get a good little sear on my gnocchi. Let that go.
And anybody who wants to know how to make that, we'll post all this stuff online too, because that was pretty easy to put together and very simple to put together.
Yep, so you can see that's starting to sizzle there in the pan. It's going to get a little crust on the bottom. Mm-hmm. You want to have a little of that texture.
Like that.
Also color. And then once that goes a little bit more, I'm going to actually add my stock.
Pour that in so slow.
And then that's going to... What that's going to do is it's going to be my sauce medium. I'm going to let that reduce a little bit.
Okay.
I'll add some of my other vegetables, which are some golden beets. Here we go. One more.
A lot of people may not know what to do with, you know, maybe some of the beets that they have, but this is a great way to put everything together, incorporate all those great colors for fall.
Yep.
Great taste for fall.
I have some celery root, if you will, celery root. So add a few of those in there.
And that's also what you use to make this, correct?
That's exactly right. A little bit of salt, just a touch of pepper.
Let that sizzle away a little bit.
And right over here, should be getting a nice color. Peek at the bottom
there. Yeah, you can see at
the bottom, yeah. Yeah, there we go.
And you're going to finish this off in the oven as well, right?
Yep, I'm actually going to go right into the oven right now.
Okay, let's step out of your way. Pop that in. And how long is this going to sit in here?
That's going to be in there for anywhere from 3 to 5 minutes, depending how thick it is.
Right. All right. Now, let's talk about the restaurant, because you, as a chef, you work at the Boathouse. You've got some great seafood. Obviously, summertime is a great time for you to be a chef, especially there, because they love the seafood so much. Talk about fall. What are some of the new things that you bring in at fall, and you still incorporate all the seafood with it?
You know, the root vegetables, the squashes. Really love this time of the year for the herbs, sage, things like that. It's just such a vibrant time of the year for colors and flavors. I love it. Yeah.
Yeah, it really does. It adds stuff that, you know, throughout the rest of the year, maybe you're not able to incorporate into a lot of the foods that you make. Even the display that you have before us today, that is a fall display. It's warm, hearty food that you're putting together.
Yep. So this is starting to reduce. It probably has another minute or so at least, and then I'm going to actually start making the sauce.
All right.
Okay. So I'm just going to grab that. You want to find me a dinner plate?
Sure. I have a dinner plate. I can do that for you. Please. This here?
Oh, that's perfect.
Perfect.
That's perfect.
Look at that, huh? That there. Let that simmer for a little bit. I'm going to flip this pan on just low here, just for a little bit.
Okay, so I'm going to add just a couple drops of vinegar. It's going to add a nice little acidity to that sauce.
Okay.
And I have some walnuts here that I toasted.
Love those.
To give some nice flavor to the dish. And then...
You have some butter there as well?
Yep, I'm going to finish this sauce with butter. I just need to reduce that just a little bit more. Actually, I'm going to pour some of that sauce off.
Okay. Put that in.
All right, so now I'm going to turn that heat down because I don't want it to boil once I add the butter.
All right.
And then I'm just going to add the butter in.
I'm going to put that in.
A few of those.
Let that go for a little bit.
And then I'm going to swirl it.
All right. And that's going to make some of the sauce. And we are going to show you actually the finished product in just a little bit. If you would like this recipe or more information about the Boathouse, you can head on over to our website. It's roadshow.com.